God bless you as you listen. Holy Spirit, Spirit, fill your church again. 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 We want to see Jesus and your Spirit flow in your church again. We want to see Jesus and your Spirit flow in your house again. Holy Spirit, Spirit, fill your church again.
In the mighty name of ara mi run pelu iba igba to ku fun mi ti ma lo ninu aye oruwa olorun mi lowo ni oruko na jesu erun mi lowo oruwa erun mi lowo oruwa erun mi lowo
lati o no my father
oruwa olorun baba
help me not to show myself
erun mi lowo lati ma se
mi any time that I have left in the mighty name of Jesus help me o lord help me o lord help me o lord in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say every satanic program targeted against the time that I have left. Every satanic program ahead of him to glorify all his goodness.
Lati mu ibaje ba ise rere re.
Close your eyes and pray.
Awa diju gbadura lapo.
Say every agenda of darkness.
Asa gbogbo ope ojo
ado re. This my testimony.
Lati fi ori mi gbole.
The enemy fail to prosper against his life.
Ọ̀tá kùnà láti ṣe rere lórí ayé rẹ̀.
Why?
Kí nìdí?
The father pray for him.
Bàbá gba àdúrà fún.
You will raise up your hand.
A gbé ọwọ́ wa sókè.
And you ask God.
A wá sọ fọlọ́run.
Say, oh Lord, my father.
Olúwa Ọlọ́run bàbá mi.
I need your help tonight.
Mo nílò ìrànlọ́wọ́ ọ̀rẹ́ láti.
Pray for me.
Gbàdúrà fún.
In the name of Jesus.
Olúwa Ọlọ́run bàbá mi.
Father, pray for me tonight. Lord, I need your help. Lord, pray for me. Lord, pray for me. Lord, pray for me. I need your help tonight. Father, pray for me. I cannot do without you. You many times that I have blessed. My energy cannot do it. My power cannot do it. My wisdom cannot carry me through. Father, pray for me. Father, pray for me. Father, pray for me. I need your help, oh Lord. Lord, pray for me. Lord, pray for me. Lord, pray for me. Holy Ghost, pray for me. Holy Ghost, pray for me. Holy Ghost, pray for me. My wisdom cannot carry me. My intelligence cannot carry me. My power cannot carry me. Holy Ghost, pray for 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 me tonight. Pray for me tonight. Pray for me tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, pray for me tonight. In the name of
Jesus.
Holy Ghost, pray for me tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, there is no mountain that we cannot climb. There is no mountain that we cannot climb. When I say me, I mean Jesus and God. When I walk with Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Oh, Father, we thank you for this night.
We
want to appreciate you for this
hour.
We bless your holy name, O Lord, for this time of refreshing. To you alone be all the glory in the name of Jesus. Lord, we charge this environment now with the fire of the Holy Ghost and the blood of Jesus.
Command
every power in this arena to submit to us in the name of Jesus. Take authority over this vicinity. And we command everything around this environment
to
cooperate with us. Stay here in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you have answered. Jesus' mighty name we pray.
God
bless. Let us open our eyes and have
our seats.
I want to bless God for the opportunity given to each and every one of us to be here tonight.
Mo fe fi ibuku fun Olorun fun anfani to fun wa bi enikankan lati wa ni bi loni.
I pray we not miss this opportunity in the name of Jesus. I want to appreciate the grace of God in the life of our father and our mommy here tonight.
Bakan na ni mo yo Olorun fun ore ofe re lori aye awon baba ati mama wa ni bi loni.
Because it's through their obedience that give us the grace to be here tonight.
Nitori pe nipasẹ igboro won Olorun wa ni bi ni irole ni asale.
The Lord will come to multiply his grace upon your life in the name of Jesus.
Mo ti gbadura pe Olorun yo ma so ore ofe re di pupo lori aye yin.
Thank God for the privilege to be standing before us tonight. Privilege to be standing before us tonight. To take this message.
Lati se iwasu yi.
And I pray.
Mo si gbadura.
The Almighty God.
Wipe Olorun alagbara.
We prosper by his word in Jesus' name.
Yo bu wa se rere ninu oro re ni
orukọ. The second message for this program.
Iwasu keji fun eto yi.
Title.
Ni a pe akori re ni.
Battle.
Ogun.
That leaders must overcome.
Èyí tí àwọn aṣáájú gbọ́dọ̀ borí.
Battles that leaders must overcome.
Àwọn ogun tí àwọn aṣáájú gbọ́dọ̀ borí rẹ̀.
Brethren,
ara
life generally is a battleground.
Ayé ní pàápàá jùlọ jẹ́ ilé ìjà.
So anybody that come to this world.
Ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá wá sí ayé.
Must ready to fight.
Ó gbọ́dọ̀ gbaradì láti
jẹ́. Whether you are a leader.
Bóyá aṣáájú ni.
Whether you are a follower.
Bàbá àtẹ̀lé ni ọ́.
Anybody that find himself on the side of the heart.
Ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá ti bá ara rẹ̀ lórí.
Must know.
Ó gbọ́dọ̀ mọ̀ dájú.
That he must fight.
Ó gbọ́dọ̀ jagun.
Failure to fight the necessary battle of life.
Kíkùnà láti jẹ ogun tó yẹ nínú ayé.
Can make one to die unfulfilled.
Ó lè mú kí ènìyàn kú láì kò wá sí ìmúṣẹ.
You fail to fight.
Tó bá kùnà tó ọjà.
You may die unfulfilled.
O lè mú ènìyàn kú.
I pray this morning. You will not die unfulfilled in the name of Jesus. But as the battle of life is.
Ṣùgbọ́n bí ogun ayé ti wà.
It's not a battle of gold and cutlass.
Kì í ṣe ogun tá à ń fi àdá àti ọkọ jà.
It's not a battle of missile and bombs.
Kì í ṣe ogun tá à ń yin bọ́ọ̀mù tàbí tá à ń fowó
ìjọ jà. It's not a battle of boxing and wrestling.
Kì í ṣe ogun ti ìjàkadì tàbí ti ẹ̀ṣẹ́ kíkọ.
Ephesians chapter 6.
Ìwé Efésù orí ìkẹfà.
I'm in Romans 10. The Bible says. Ephesians 6, I'm reading from verse 10.
Ìwé Efésù orí ìkẹfà. Láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹwàá.
I will read only in English because of our time. The Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the old armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against the flesh and the blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil days, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girded about with truth, and having in the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit with the word of God. Pray always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints, and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in bonds, that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. Brethren, as leaders in the house of God,
if you fail
to overcome this battle that we want to talk about tonight,
you may not be able
to speak the way you ought to speak. You may not be able to get him out to do what? To speak the way you ought to what? To speak. If you fail in this battle, you may not have the boldness to declare the message that I've been giving unto you. You may not have the ability to discharge your duty as a leader. So, leader in the house of God is not a call of bread and butter.
It's
not leader to be serving tables. It's not leader to be running here and there. It is a deep calling that you need to overcome some things within you. Before you can discharge your duty effectively. A good understanding of your environment and where you operate is the first step to take to overcome the battle of life. Otherwise, you may be fighting a useless battle. As a leader, you need a clear understanding of your environment. You need a clear understanding of where you are operating. You need a clear understanding of the power that are ruling over your vicinity. You need a clear understanding of the dominating spirit in your environment. If you have this understanding in your possession, it can promote exercise in futility. I pray tonight, you will not labor in vain in Jesus'
name.
Brethren, we read from that book of Ephesians,
Nino, iwe, fesu ti akaye,
that the weapons of our warfare, that we do not wrestle against the flesh and the blood, but against principalities, against powers, spiritual wickedness,
in high places. That will be giga.
Brethren, may I shock you tonight? Though these powers, they are strong on their own. But for you to be able to overcome these powers, for you to be able to silence them, number one battle that must overcome is the battle over yourself. Many ministers are falling from grace to grace today. Because of their inability to overcome self.
I, me, and myself.
But as a leader in the house of God,
you are a servant.
But yourself, we not see you, we not allow you to see yourself as a servant. We be making you to see yourself that I am the boss here. The spirit of self, we make you to see yourself that I am the boss in place.
He'll
be telling you that I'm the one that's in charge in this place. I'm the one that is issuing instruction in this place. And
now
you know what happened.
Others
will be coming.
That
will not allow the work of God in the hand of such leader to bring forth fruit. And
Sarah
will not just operate or come out just like that. It starts from a place. And that is why this next one I want to mention is very, very important. And if you fail to overcome this one I want to mention, which is connected to one I've mentioned before. I tell you, you cannot overcome any principalities. You cannot overcome any spiritual wickedness. You cannot overcome any powers. You cannot command any demon that will obey you. What is this battle that I'm talking about?
It's
the battle of your mind. Battle of your mind. Battle of your mind. Any minister that will make an expert for God. Must overcome the battle of the mind. Let me shock you tonight. Not everything that comes out of your mind is correct.
It's
not everything that comes out of your mind is correct. That's why
I'm saying
book of 10. That we break down everyone's imaginations. We break down every imagination.
Say,
no, I walk in the flesh and no war after the flesh.
Remember,
we are talking a battle that leaders must overcome. So when you are fighting a battle, you are winning a war. And the Bible says, though I walk in the flesh, you must not walk after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not what?
And
it is magic to God to be pulling down our strongholds.
So
one of the strongholds that
will
be pulled down as leaders in the house of God is the stronghold of your mind.
Lara, why big guy eat a better work pallet? Gagabi, I shall do a lot of dinner and then you shall know.
When our mind is not conforming with the will of the Almighty God, you will be serving and you will think
you
are serving God, but you will be doing everything in flesh. I pray we will not serve God in vain in the mighty name of Jesus. I say we will not serve God in vain in the mighty name of
Jesus.
I told you earlier that not everything that comes out of your mind is correct.
So
any thought of your mind must be thoroughly checked with the word of God. You must make sure that the thought of your mind is conforming with the will of the Almighty Father. Otherwise, the flesh will be leading. When you are thinking that you are serving God, there are so many people in the house of God today that they are thinking that they are leading in line with the will of God. By following what comes out of their mind, which is not correct. The Bible says something. Say many shall call in the book of Mark chapter 7.
Iwe Mark ori keje.
Matthew chapter 7.
Iwe Matthew ori keje.
See many say I come on that day.
Olo po yo wa lojo na.
Say by your name we cast out demons.
Se loruko re la name Yesu jade.
By your name we heal the sick.
Loruko re la po alaisan larada.
By your name we do so many miracles.
Loruko re la se opo ise iyanu.
And you will say,
ase wi pe,
go away from me.
Ma lo,
I do not know you.
Emi ko mo.
You workers of
iniquity. Sese.
Is working miracle iniquity?
Sese sese iyanu aise dede.
When he raised up the dead becomes an iniquity.
Nigba wo ni jijo budi dede ese.
When the healing the sick becomes an iniquity.
Nigba wo ni imu alaisan lara dade.
Why?
Kilode.
The position of the mind of the miracle worker.
Ipa e lokan onise iyanu
ni position of the mind
ipo ti
one that heal the sick
eni to mu alaisan lara da
wa position of the mind of he that opened the hand of the blind
ipo ti e lokan ni to se afoju loju wa.
So that's why I said the number one battle I must overcome as a leader.
Idi ni e ti mo fi so pe ogun akoko
for demons to bow before you.
Pe ki e mi e so le bo tari ba niwaju wa
battle of the mind.
Ogun ni ogun ero kan.
Your mind will come up with many suggestions for you.
Oko re amo ni ruru ero wa fun.
I may be using those suggestions and be making headway.
O le ma mo awon ero gba yi ko ma lo ko ma fi saju.
And if there's no check.
To ba ke si.
You may not know.
O le ma mo.
That you have already deviated.
Pe o ti yan bara.
From the plan and purpose of God for our life.
Eto ati ife Olorun fun aye
eni. The Bible tell us about different types of mind that a man carry.
Bibeli so ni ruru awon ero okan ti eniyan ni.
Number one.
Ikini.
You have a troubled mind.
A ni okan to ni iyanu.
The book of 2 Kings chapter 6.
Iwe oba keji ori kefa.
Troubled mind.
Okan to ni iyanu.
As a leader.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí
aṣáájú. You must not allow your mind to be troubled.
O gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ kí ọkàn rẹ gba ìyọnu.
Lúkọ̀ John chapter 14, Jesus Christ said, told us.
Jésù sọ fún wa nínú ìwé ìjọ.
Say, let not your mind what? Be troubled.
Ó ní kí a má ṣe jẹ́ kí ọkàn rẹ ó dàrú.
Let not your mind what? Be troubled.
Kí a má ṣe jẹ́ kí ọkàn rẹ ó dàrú.
Many ministers of God happen labor, and they find out that things are not going the way they expect.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìránṣẹ́
ọlọ́run
ti ṣe làálàá títí tí ohun ìgbòrí bó ṣe fẹ́ àwa gba ìdàrú.
Trouble mind.
Ọkàn tó ní ìyẹn.
Trouble mind.
Ọkàn tó dàrú.
Oh, I'm living a lonely life. I've done this, I've done that, but still
I'm
not working according to expectation.
Òun dẹ̀ ń ṣe onírúurú làálàá síbẹ̀ ìgbòrí bó ṣe fẹ́.
I was reading something online, I think some months ago.
Wọ́n gbà nǹkan yẹ̀wò lórí fọ́nrán ní ìgbà oṣù díẹ̀ sẹ́yìn.
There was this man in Lagos here.
Ọkùnrin kan wà nílùú Èkó yìí.
Said they went to the same school with one of the tout in Lagos.
Ó ní àwọn jọ lọ sí ilé ìwé pẹ̀lú ọmọ ọ̀tá kan nílùú Èkó.
And that one is now commissioning dedicate an hotel, a new build hotel.
Ìyẹn wá ṣí ó ń ṣe ilé ìtura.
And that one, he said, during their youth, they are moving together, but the parents is warning him.
Pẹ́ẹ́bà yẹn táwọn jọ ń rìn bọ̀, ìyá òun máa ń kìlọ̀ fún
òun. See, I don't want you with these boys. Go away from them.
Wọ́n ò fẹ́ kó bá wọn
lọ. We go to school. So the boy go to school, he went to school. He has had his first degree now, he has his second degree now. He's doing his master's now.
Ó ti kàwé gboyè lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ báyìí.
He's doing his PhD now. Sorry.
Ó tún ṣe ìwé ó kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ nípa ti ìmọ̀ ọ̀jọ̀gbọ́n.
And he said something.
Ó wá sọ nǹkan.
That I make you to know that there are some people that go to school that the school is nothing in their life.
Ó lá òun rí pé àwọn kan wà kán lọ ilé ìwé ṣùgbọ́n tí ò tẹ̀ jábọ̀.
He said it's my parents o that say I should not follow this boy.
Ó láwọn òbí òun náà jẹ́ kó ń tẹ̀lé àwọn ọkùnrin.
Say now he has influence in Lagos, he control everywhere. Now me need that read every book that I don't have anything to show up.
Ó ní báyìí ọkùnrin yẹn ló ń jẹ gàba nílùú Èkó tó nípò dáadáa. Ó lóun tó ń kàwé òun ò rí kankan.
Say even the government didn't even recognize me.
Ó ní ìjọba ò tẹ̀ mọ́ o.
But before the meeting I dey call on my friend to discuss issues of Lagos with him.
Ó ní wọ́n máa pe ọ̀rẹ́ òun yìí, wọ́n máa ta sọ̀rọ̀ nípa ìlú Èkó.
What is making that man to say so?
Kí ló ń tó mú kó sọ irú ọ̀rọ̀ bẹ́ẹ̀?
Trouble mind.
O ní ọkàn tó dàrú.
The mind is already troubled.
Ọkàn rẹ ti dàrú.
Your mind will be troubled in Jesus.
Ọkàn wọn ò ní dàrú.
Another type of mind. that will affect a leader that must try to overcome. Is a depressed mind. Depressed mind. 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 5.
1 Timothy 6 verse 5.
He said, "Perfect disputing of men of corrupt mind and destitute of the truth, supposing that gain is godliness, from such withdraw thyself." Praise the Lord. There are some people that their mind have been depressed. The Bible says you must withdraw yourself from such people. They think that when they have friends, when they have everything, that it is godliness. No, say from salt, depart away from them. Another type of mind that a leader must overcome is a sinful mind. Romans chapter 8 verse 7. There is a sinful mind. But before you do anything that's contrary to the will of God, before you go against the commandment of the Almighty God, before you say something that will affect your brother or that your sister, it
all
starts from our mind.
There
was a song that I had many years ago.
Say, you are thinking about it and you are thinking about it.
Before you take any step, it always comes from your mind. So if you want to overcome any battle in life, your mind must be pure. Another type of mind, a dull mind. The mind that is not sensitive. The mind that not know the move of God. The mind that shallow in understanding. Another type of mind is a blinded mind. 2 Corinthians 4:4. The mind that cannot see correctly. The mind that cannot see beyond the physical. The mind that cannot see into the spiritual. The mind that cannot see tomorrow. The mind that cannot know where God is taking him to. The mind that does not know what is going to happen the next hour. A blinded mind. And the last one of our time is the corrupt mind. Where we have all forms of dunks dwelling there. The
author of the
book of Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 4, verse 9. Say, the heart of man is deceitfully above all things. And desperately wicked. Who can know it? Who can know it? There are some leaders today that are deceiving themselves. If you have the call of God upon your life as a leader, if you know the word God has contained your hands, you cannot afford to keep on deceiving yourself. You must be able to tell yourself the truth. Am I in line with God has committed to my hands? Am I in line according to the expectation of heaven over my life? Am I in the purpose of God for my life? There are so many leaders today that they are busy in the assignment of other people. Because of the battle in their minds. Today, in ministry. There are so many diverse ministries. Ababa told us. We have different offices. Like our pastor mentioned when he was opening the program.
The book of
Ephesians chapter 4. We have those offices there. But some leader will sit down. And we look at some other leader. And something will come up from their mind.
And
he sees that the one that this one is doing is the eating now. And that's why people are rushing there.
And then we
say, let me bend a little bit. And in a bend.
Maybe not in you.
And as he bend,
but in you,
you may be, it's not maybe coming. It's not maybe coming. And
he
may be there. People may be coming. And without knowing, the assignment that everyone has committed to his or hand, you will have left it undone. Because his mind has deceived him. Your mind will not deceive you. I
say
your mind will not deceive you. But I'm talking you what is happening at this end time. Number one battle that you must overcome as a leader in the house of God. The battle of our mind. That is the center of the battleground. Our mind is the battlefield.
Where
we wage war against principalities, against the powers, spiritual wickedness, against demons, against with it. It is from your mind. If you believe that nothing will happen to you and you are living your life in that way, God, nothing will happen to you.
The
Bible says, "If God be for us, who can be against us?" But if your mind is not in tune with the word of God, if your mind is not stable,
friend,
you'll be living a defeated life. I pray for you today. You will not live a defeated life in the name of
Jesus.
Many Christian leaders are falling today as a result of the thought of their mind. When I was preparing for this message, when I saw battle that leaders must overcome, it was another that was coming from my mind. Yes. All of a sudden, I have to stop. What's wrong? I have to check me. Say, for you to overcome all this one we are talking about. Yes, a father of them all.
That's
the battle of the mind. The victory of David over Goliath started from his mind. Physically, the man was unfit to confront Goliath.
In experience,
he was unfit to confront Goliath. The leaders of the city, they cannot face Goliath. Because for 40 days and nights, the man was coming out and the king was cannot open his mouth to talk. But when David came,
the
man that his mind is in tune with the word of God, something quickly came out of his mind. This man cannot be stronger than lion. This man cannot be stronger than that bear that I killed the other time. This man cannot be stronger than the people that have overcome before. All of a sudden,
no Gigi.
Strength came
Okunde
from within.
Lati Inua.
And The king,
Oba.
All what he has put upon him to conquer Goliath. He told the king, saying, I cannot go with this.
Say,
I cannot go with this. What make you to pull out?
His
mind was strengthened from within.
Only way I think you are more
I want to close your eyes.
My father.
As I am praying now, strengthen my mind down.
To
be an overcomer. In the name of Jesus. Strengthen my mind to be an overcomer. In the name of Jesus. My father. Strengthen my mind to be an overcomer. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, oh Lord, my Father, give me a strong mind to overcome all evil. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord, my Father, give me a strong mind to overcome all evil. In the mighty name of Jesus, give me a strong mind to overcome all evil. In the mighty name of Jesus, give me a strong mind to overcome all evil. The book of Philippians. I can do all things in Christ. That strengthens me. What's that? The power of the mind. As a leader, you must know that there's an ability inside of you. Something has been deposited in you that will not allow you to fail. When you pray, the prayer will receive an answer. To command and devil will hear you. Instead of you to make a decree and shall be established in heaven. Instead of you to ban and to remain banned. Instead of you to lose and they will remain
loose.
If you have overcome the battle of your mind. Overcome the battle of your mind. I remember many years ago when I was growing. When I want to pray for the sick. I begin to pray again. What happened? What's the problem? My mind is not stable. And I'll be afraid. Can you imagine this prayer now? When such a mind cannot overcome any battle. I pray for us tonight. Lord, will give us understand what I'm saying tonight in the name of Jesus. I
say,
God, give us understanding of what God is going to be in the name of Jesus.
Brother,
what I say tonight? Your mind is very, very important. As a leader, to carry out the assignment that God has committed to your hand effectively. When you overcome the battle of your mind, there are some other battles that you step upon easily. Brethren, when you see a man, a leader, you must overcome sin.
overcome sin and iniquity.
Right?
You cannot overcome sin and iniquity without overcoming the battle of your mind.
Oh, le bori ogun ese ati aisedede laipo ba bori.
If your mind keeps on telling you a lie, it means that your mind has connected you to the Satan, with the father of lies.
O je pe okore ti so po mo Satani to je baba iro niyan.
And when you have been already connected with the father of all lies,
nipa ta ba ti so po mo baba okuro,
what service are you going to do for God?
Ki wa ni ise esin to fe se?
Which kind of leader will you provide?
I asaju wo lo fe je?
Who will be leading you?
Ta lo wa fe dari re?
I say God will deliver us in the mighty name of Jesus. So you must deal with your mind.
Obodo sise lori okan re.
No wonder the book of Romans chapter 12.
O ya ni lenu nigbati we Rome orike.
Come somebody go. The book of Romans chapter 12.
Abe kan ba wa si.
Romans 12.
We Rome orike jila.
I beseech you therefore,
brethren,
by the mercies of God,
that
you present your body a living sacrifice,
that you present yourself a living sacrifice,
only acceptable,
which is your reasonable service
as a leader,
and be not conformed
to this world, but be transformed by renewing your mind.
Yes. Your life cannot be transformed as a leader to do exploit without renewing your mind.
Be transformed by the renewing of your mind,
that ye may prove that which is good
and acceptable,
and perfect will of God. I don't know the reason why you are serving as a leader in the house of God. I don't know the reason why you are one of the ministers or the leaders in the house of God. I don't know what is your focus. I don't know what your vision is. But
in
what you attend,
in what
you do according to every expectation, if your leadership powers have been transformed, it is only by the renewing your mind.
Nipasẹ pe o tun okan re se ni o yi
pada. Mind must be renewed.
Okan re gbọdọ gba ọtun.
Leaders in the house.
Asaju ni
ile. Pastors in the house.
Oluso agutu
ni ile. Ministers in the house.
Iranṣẹ Ọlọrun ninu ile.
What is the state of your mind?
Nipo ayewo ni okan re wa.
What is the state of your mind?
Ayewo ni okan
re wa. Until you overcome the battle of your mind.
Ayafi igba to ba bori ogun ero okan.
You cannot be a worthy servant.
Oh, le jẹ osise to ye.
That's what the Bible says.
Tori na ni Bible fi so fun wa.
Eniyan moju. Olorun o kini. You will be talking here and there.
Ale ma fo soke
fun. You will be telling to be telling yourself what you are not.
Ale ma so fun ra won ta o je.
You may be calling you different names.
Awon eyan le ma pe wa loniruru oruko.
Is only label on the bottle.
Afihan.
Your mind is your content. That is where the original thing resides. That is where the original service comes from. That is where the
original ministration comes from.
That is where
the true service comes from.
I pray tonight.
Pray to overcome the battle of our mind.
God
will give it unto us in the name of Jesus. As ministers, as leaders,
there's
a battle that I must overcome. But it
will
be very, very easy to overcome them. Once overcome the battle of your mind, I will mention them for you. Number one, as leaders, you must overcome ignorance in your life. Ignorance is a serious battle. If a leader fails to know what he ought to know,
what
a leader
will
become.
That
one
that
has admonishes as leader in the house of God. You must study to show yourself approved.
After
when I listen to people, some people are ministering. Because we listen in letters.
Or last one,
ordinary letters.
Or
you will know that this thing is not from the spirit. It's not
different.
Why? Spiritual ignorance.
I know you hear me.
You can't interpret the Bible with educational knowledge.
The
Bible says, look of 1 Peter chapter 2.
Bible is
that it is the spiritual that you can understand the spiritual matter. Yes. You cannot decode what is in the spirit without the spirit of God inside of you.
Oh, le Dieu tiemi laiko tiemi Olorun ninu.
So, you must overcome the battle of ignorance.
Obado bori ogun aloye.
If you want to be a successful leader in this generation,
to ba fe je alaseyori asaju ninu iran yi.
Another battle to overcome.
Ogun mi,
this battle over powerlessness.
Ojo ogun ailagba ailagbara tabi ogun ainipa.
We need the power of God as leaders.
A nilo agbara Olorun gege bi asaju.
We cannot do without power.
A o le se gankan lai ko ba si
agbara. Let me say something.
Bible is so gone.
That in the day of his power, people shall be willing.
Oni nigba.
The reason why there's no willingness in the house of God today, because there's no manifestation of power. When people see the power of God manifest in a place,
and
then you don't need any anger, they will come there. They will come there. When they see the power of God at work. When they see the power of God demonstrated on
daily basis,
when the day of his power, people shall be willing. And a battle to overcome as a leader. You overcome battle over Satan's sponsors attack in the church. There are some attacks that are being sponsored by the power of darkness in the house of God. And your eyes will not be blind against it. Now when the Bible admonishes us, you must not be ignorant about the devices of what? Of this devil. Another battle that I must overcome as leaders. Thank God our daddy has mentioned it. Idleness. A leader that is idle.
Ashaju to
can be put to do anything anyhow. There's a saying that says an idle hand is the what? In the workshop of the devil. You are paid to be a leader. What do you carry in your hand? What is in your hand? What are you doing for God now? What assignment are you doing for the state? What are you doing for the nation? What are you doing in the family? What are you doing for the society?
gẹ́gẹ́ bí aṣáájú.
Or just leadership by portfolio alone.
Àbọ̀kàn jẹ́ afẹnu jẹ́ aṣáájú ni.
As a leader you must overcome idleness in our life.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí aṣáájú a gbọ́dọ̀ borí àìríkanṣe nínú
ọ̀rọ̀. Another battle that you must overcome as a leader.
Ogun mi ta tún gbọ́dọ̀ borí gẹ́gẹ́ bí aṣáájú.
Is the battle of loneliness.
Òun ni ogun àdáni kan wà.
Battle of what?
Ogun àdáni kan.
Loneliness. Brethren, if there is anything that can kill a leader suddenly, it's loneliness.
Tàbárò tó ń ṣe fún aṣáájú kíákíá òun ni kó dá wà.
Loneliness is when a leader don't have a good followers and supporters around him.
Nígbà tí aṣáájú ò bá ní àtẹ̀lé rere tàbí alátìlẹyìn rere.
You must not allow this to happen to you.
Kò gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ kí èyí ó ṣẹlẹ̀.
As leader, you must pray for faithful followers around you, supporters around you.
A gbọ́dọ̀ gbàdúrà fún àwọn olóòótọ́ ènìyàn ní àyíká wa tí ó tẹ̀lé wa lẹ́yìn.
When I was preparing this message, God, I just stumbled into the book of Joshua. When Joshua and Moses, they want to confront the Amalekites.
Àtọ́ ṣe àgbékalẹ̀ ẹ̀kọ́ yìí, wọ́n mú obì kan nínú Bíbélì, Joshua àti Mose nígbà tí wọ́n fẹ́ lọ
bá Amalekites. And the battle was fierce and long.
Nígbà tó gùn ìgbóná jọjọ.
And the anytime that Moses up his hand, they were winning the battle.
Tí Mose bá ti gbé ọwọ́ sókè, wọ́n máa borí nínú
ogun. They keep on winning the battle.
Wọ́n máa borí
nínú ogun. Anytime the hand was heavy and put it down.
Nígbà tapá bá ro tó gbọ́wọ́ wá
dé. The enemy begin to overcome.
Wọ́n máa bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí borí.
All of a sudden.
Lójijì.
Because he had good supporters.
Nítorí kó láwọn alátìlẹyìn.
He took a decision.
Ó mú ìpinnu kan.
He said we must help our leader.
Wọ́n ní a gbọ́dọ̀ ran aṣáájú wa lọ́wọ́.
And they hold the hand.
Wọ́n wá jì lọ́wọ́ mú.
They hold the hand.
Wọ́n gbé ọwọ́ yẹn sókè.
You know, by the time they hold the hand.
Bí wọ́n ti gbé ọwọ́
yẹn. Who is the feeling the pain?
Tani ọ apá máa
ń lo. They are the one that be feeling the pain o.
Wọ́n jì lọ́wọ́ mú ni.
Yes, because his own hand has received some support.
Torí ọwọ́ ọtí ọ ti ní ohun tó sinmi lé.
Faithful followers.
Àwọn atẹ̀lé
ọ̀rọ̀. Who supporters.
Àwọn alátìlẹyìn.
But when a leader has nobody like that around him.
Ṣé aṣáájú ò bá rírú ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀ láyìíká rẹ̀?
Work is very very difficult.
Iṣẹ́ yẹn á ṣòro lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀.
Guys, I love football.
Mo fẹ́ràn bọ́ọ̀lù àfẹ́fẹ́.
Guys, a team in England.
Àwọn ìsọ̀rí kan wà ní ìlú England.
Their slogan is never work alone.
Ọ̀rọ̀ àṣà wọn ni pé má dárìn.
You know the team? Never what? Never work alone.
Má dárìn.
There as a leader you need support.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí aṣáájú onílò olùrànlọ́wọ́.
You cannot do it alone by yourself.
Ṣé a nìkan ṣe fúnra rẹ̀?
No matter your anointing.
Kò ní bó ṣe wù kí
àgbàdo. No matter your strength.
Bó ti ṣe wù kí agbára
rẹ̀. You need somebody beside you. Your Moses needs Joshua.
Mose rẹ̀ ó nílò Joshua.
Your Elijah needs Elijah.
Elijah rẹ̀ nílò Elijah.
Your Moses needs Aaron.
Mose rẹ̀ nílò.
Your Paul needs a Barnabas.
Paul rẹ nílò Barnabas.
Your Peter must be accompanied with John.
Pétérù rẹ nílò Jòhánù.
For the work that God has committed to your hands.
Nítorí iṣẹ́ tọ́lọ́run ti
fi yẹn. I pray for you tonight and myself.
Gbàdúrà fún ọlọ́dẹ àtàrà.
We will not work alone in the mighty name of Jesus. I say not work alone in the name of Jesus. Brethren, I want to round up now.
Ara mo fẹ́ mú ẹnu dúró.
How can you overcome this battle?
Báwo la ṣe lè borí àwọn ogun wọ̀nyí?
Number one.
Ìkíní.
We need a closer walk with God.
A nílò bíbọ Ọlọ́run rìn ní
tí. We need what?
Bíbọ Ọlọ́run rìn ní
tí. A closer what? Walk with God.
Bíbọ Ọlọ́run rìn ní tímọ́tímọ́.
Thank God for the leading of the Holy Spirit of our Father in the Lord.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ ìjárí ẹ̀mí mọ́ nínú ayé.
Na this year that we are in.
Wípé nínú ọdún tí
a wà. Is our year of a closer walk with God.
Ó jẹ́ ọdún bíbọ Ọlọ́run rìn ní
tímọ́. You want to be a leader, I want to live effectively.
Ó fẹ́ jẹ́ adarí oṣù bẹ́ẹ̀ darí bó ṣe tọ́nà.
You must work closely with God.
Ó gbọ́dọ̀ bá Ọlọ́run rìn tímọ́.
How can you work closely with God?
Báwo ló ṣe lè bá Ọlọ́run rìn tímọ́tímọ́?
Have a daily fellowship with God.
Ó gbọ́dọ̀ ní ìdàpọ̀ lójoojúmọ́ pẹ̀lú Ọlọ́run.
By reading your Bible.
Nípa kíka Bíbélì rẹ.
By praying.
Nípa gbígba àdúrà.
By listening to God.
Àti nípa tẹ́tí sílẹ̀ fún Ọlọ́run.
Let God speak to you.
Jẹ́ kọ́lọ́run ó bá ọ sọ̀rọ̀.
Let God talk to you on daily basis.
Jẹ́ kọ́lọ́run ó bá ọ sọ̀rọ̀ ní.
Receive the word from the Lord on daily basis.
Gbá ọ̀rọ̀ lẹ́nu Ọlọ́run lójoojúmọ́.
That's what you can do to maintain a closer walk with God.
By hating
those things that God hates. By loving things that God loves. These are the ways of having a closer walk with God. What must you do again to overcome the battle as a leader? Do not compare yourself with anybody. See yourself as someone that is having a unique ministry. See yourself that God has committed your hand what God has not committed to the hand of any other person. So if you
are
under
understanding,
not be
strong
with anybody. You know
something
with anybody. Number three thing.
Oh, we get
to overcome battle of life as a leader. You must be led by the Spirit. And be filled with the Spirit.
You
must be led by the Spirit of God.
You
must be filled with the Spirit of God. Any leader in this generation that wants to make an impact must have some spiritual gifts functioning in your life. The one that is most important among them. So that you not fall victim of fake followers.
Discernment
spirit. And
it
is the spirit that is not that is found wanting among the leaders today. Leaders that cannot discern between good and evil. Leaders that can only see with two eyes ball. They can't see beyond the physical. So if you want to overcome battle of life as a leader, you must have a discernment spirit. The spirit that is operating in the church today is the spirit of deceit. I pray
you
not be deceived in Jesus' name. There is a spirit that is on assignment to deceive leaders. So as a leader, don't be carried away with eyesight.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí aṣáájú, má ṣe jẹ́ kí ojú ayé má
jẹ́ kó bí ẹni. Somebody is moving here and there does not mean that is making impact.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni kan gbọ̀n sí bí gbọ̀n sọ́hun ò túmọ̀ sí pé ó ń kópa.
You have must have a discernment spirit.
O gbọ́dọ̀ ní ẹ̀mí
ìdáhùn. To be able to see into the spirit realm.
O gbọ́dọ̀ lórí ohun tí ń ṣe ti ẹ̀mí.
What God is saying at a particular point in time.
Kan tọ́lọ́run ń sọ ní àkókò kan.
What must you do again?
Kí ló tó tún gbọ́dọ̀ ṣe?
You must increase yourself in the knowledge of the word of God.
O gbọdọ mu ara re po si ninu imo oro Olorun.
As a leader, if you don't increase yourself in the knowledge of your word, in your knowledge in the word of God,
to ba je ki o po si ninu imo oro Olorun,
you can't overcome any battle.
O le bori ogunkogun.
You cannot overcome any battle.
O le bori
ogunkogun. In the book of Matthew chapter 4. When the devil came, even to tempt our Lord Savior, he said, it is written. It is written. If you don't read, you don't know what is written there. If you don't open it, you cannot know what is written there. You must make Bible to be your friend on daily basis. And that is why in this commission, every name must use at least 7 chapters of the Bible.
Today.
By the time you have the word of God in your life, you'll be able
Wale.
To stand before men and declare the mandate of heaven.
Wale pashe,
do to overcome the battle as a leader.
Oh, me, it's
a life of prayer and fasting.
Prayer and fasting.
Let me tell you, to overcome the battle of the mind, you need fasting. that your fast will put the flesh under subjection. A fasting life will destroy the strength of the flesh inside of you. A life of fasting will kill every evil appetite inside your life. A life of fasting will destroy every kind of manipulation from within against you. And that's why Jesus Christ was telling the disciples in the book of Mark chapter 17 verse 21 that this kind goeth not. Because their mind is having problem. Because their faith is shallow. And that's the next thing that you do to overcome battle as a leader. Increase your faith in God. Your what? Your faith. Bible says, if you have faith, you will say unto this mountain, make you move and go to the sea, and shall be so.
Well,
we need faith like never before. For us to experience the power of God in this generation, we need faith. For us to see the great working power of God, we need faith. Brother, let us add to our faith that our God is still alive. And I pray tonight, as you are addressing to all these things, Lord, will make us to be an effective leader in the name of Jesus. A love of holiness. It's very, very a life of love as a leader. If you are be a leader and then love, humility, a leader with pride,
cannot
make an effective leadership. When you have all these things in you, the Bible says, the Bible says that if you make it to be more effective in making your calling and in election sure. Shall we rise up in our feet? Tell God. I open myself unto you tonight. Renew my mind tonight. By the power of your word that I've had. In the mighty name of Jesus. Renew my mind tonight. By the power of your word that I've had. In the mighty name of Jesus. Renew my mind tonight. By the power of your word that I've had. In the mighty name of Jesus.
In Jesus'
mighty name we pray. Say every battle targeted against my mind, I overcome you tonight. In the name of Jesus, I overcome tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, every battle targeted against my mind, I overcome tonight. In the name of Jesus, every battle against my mind, I overcome tonight. In the name of Jesus, I overcome you tonight. In the name of Jesus, every battle targeted against my mind, I overcome tonight. In the name of Jesus, I overcome tonight. In the name of Jesus, I overcome tonight. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
The
fire of God, make away now. Every shelter in my heart, in your mighty name of Jesus, make away now. If you shelter that in my heart, make away now. By far, 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 by far,
Mighty name, I will pray.
Whether
you are going to follow the prayer up with this. Say, oh Lord, my Father. Plant me in an environment of fruitfulness. Say, oh Lord, my Father. Plant me in an environment of fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray that prayer.
Oh Lord,
my Father. Plant me in an environment of fruitfulness. In the mighty name of Jesus. Plant me in an environment of fruitfulness. In the mighty name of
Jesus.
In Jesus' precious name, I pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ti o seye bi eni ati gba adura.
We are in the prayer session now.
Awa ninu ipele adura kan bayi.
Title.
Eti o ni.
Oh God.
Olorun.
Let your call be plain to me.
Je ki pe re ki o se kedere si mi.
Oh God.
Olorun.
Let your call be plain to me.
Je ki pe re ki o se kedere si mi.
And then before we pray the prayer.
I'm not going to be right?
A man called Samuel.
Oh, could you tell me this Samuel?
Was in the life, was in the house of a man called Eli.
Oh, what? You know, could you tell me Eli?
For three consecutive times.
Full Igba meta ototo.
God called this thing Samuel.
Oh, Lord, we Samuel, you
he was unable to recognize the voice.
But immediately
the call of God was made plain to the man called Samuel. There was an account in the Bible. That this same man called Samuel. He was a man. That whatever he says.
Pe ohun gbogbo ti won ba so.
He will surely come to pass. It means the call of God was clearly to him.
O fun pe ipe Olorun o se kedere si.
He was able to exhibit the call of God upon his life.
Ó ní àǹfààní láti lè gbé ìṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ nínú ìpín Ọlọ́run fún ayé rẹ̀.
And why tonight you are going to pray clearly like this?
Ó wà gbàdúrà náà gbangba báyìí.
Say, oh God, my father.
Ọlọ́run bàbá mi.
Open my eyes tonight.
Ẹ lọ ojú mi ní àṣálẹ̀ yìí.
For your call upon my life to be made known. He says, I will stand upon my watch.
Maduro lori petele.
And set me upon the tower.
Ki o si gbe mi sori mi soso ni.
And I will watch to see what he will say unto me.
Mo si ma woye ohun ti yo so fun mi.
And what I shall answer when I am reproved.
Ati ohun ti won o da lohun igba ta ba ba mi wi.
And the Lord answered me.
Olorun si da lohun.
And said, And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision.
Call Irono.
And make it plain upon the table. That he may run that readeth it. That whosoever that readeth what? The vision may run with the vision. That is why you are going to open your mouth and pray this prayer. Say, my father, my father, my father. Say, my father, my father, my father. Your call upon my life shall not be destroyed. The call of God upon my life shall not be destroyed.
Ìpè inú rẹ̀ ayé mi kò ní dìbàjẹ́.
Then you